Well, hi there. I'm here today with my two gopher snakes, Buttercup and Inigo Montoya, because we want to talk to you guys about gopher snakes, pine snakes, and bull snakes, the genus Pituophis, because these are some of my very favorite snakes in the whole world. They're a really excellent size, they look really cool, and they make excellent pets. But are they the right pet snake for you? Overall, we give gopher, bull, and pine snakes a score of 4.0 out of 5. That will come down to our five categories, which are handleability, care, hardiness, availability, and upfront costs. When it comes to handleability, we give gopher, bull, and pine snakes a score of 4 out of 5. They're a little bit smaller than some snakes, but they're still pretty robust. They're just a little bit skinnier than, say, like a ball python or a boa. For that reason, they could be more easily injured than those snakes, but they're still pretty robust. As babies especially, they can be a little bit grumpy. Some of them are prone to biting, and it really depends a lot on the species and population and just the individual that you have. Generally speaking though, I find that they tend to be bluffers, but that bluff is pretty scary. They rattle their tail, which makes a loud rattling noise. They puff up like a rattlesnake. They get into kind of a rattlesnake up S position, and then they mock strike at you and hiss really loud, and that is frightening. But once you pick them up, usually they're just calm as can be, generally speaking. They're usually not very darty, like they don't zip around like a garter snake does. They will just kind of hang out like this. They can move, but they tend to be kind of slow and methodical when they move. Even when you see them in the wild, if you see a big individual, it's usually just like laying out across a path somewhere and you come up to it and it just doesn't even care. And it just slowly makes its way across, kind of king of the road. Really the only thing to be aware of is just like any snake, you shouldn't handle them for a couple of days after feeding. You don't want them to regurgitate from stress because that can cause a lot of problems for your snake. When it comes to care, we give gopher, bull, and pine snakes a score of 5 out of 5. Care is frankly very easy as far as a reptile goes. They do really well in both snake racks or in glass aquaria, assuming you've got a good lid on there. If you don't have a good lid, you will not have a snake anymore. It'll be somewhere else in your house. And that's just the truth of it. Water is key for these guys and most animals. You know, you can kill anything if you don't give it water. They only need to be fed about once a week and they can go longer than that. If you go on vacation or something, just make sure their water bowl is full. Give them something to eat and then leave, right? How many pets are like that? Snakes are awesome. Assuming that the individual you get is captive bred, they're gonna be very, very easy to feed. They like food a lot. If you have a problem with rodents, even frozen thawed rodents, then snakes in general are probably just not for you. There are a few that don't eat rodents, but they tend to be a little bit tougher in general than the rodent-eating snakes. Probably the best one that I would recommend that doesn't have to be fed a staple diet of rodents are garter snakes, and we have a video for them already. You can check that out. And the other big thing on top of food and water and not letting it out is just to make sure that you keep their temperatures right, and the best way to do this is gonna be with heat tape or a heat mat and a thermostat. And we have links to all these things down in the description. When it comes to hardiness, we give these guys a score of 5 out of 5. The truth is, they're just solid as a reptile can be. You give them water, food, appropriate temperatures, they're gonna do great. They're just as good as it gets. When it comes to availability, we give gopher, pine, and bull snakes a score of 2 out of 5. This is honestly where they lose the biggest chunk of points. They can be found. They're out there. They're for sale all the time. It's just you're gonna need to look, and you're probably gonna need to find a breeder online. That's the most likely place that you'll find one. Once you find a breeder, I mean, there are lots of different species available, lots of different morphs of the species that are available, so there's a lot of cool-looking pine gopher and bull snakes out there. It's just a matter of finding them. Expos, breeders, and of course, like I already mentioned, online, those are gonna be the best places you're gonna find them. You're just usually not gonna find them, say, in your local pet store. And that's just because they're underrated. There just aren't that many people producing these, and so there are some, you can find them, but not everybody's gonna sell them. When it comes to upfront costs, we give these guys a score of 4 out of 5. Because they are fairly fecund, meaning they lay a lot of eggs at a time every year, a lot are born for every pairing. And because they're so underrated, those babies that are produced are affordable. They're not very expensive. Probably the most expensive thing will be that you'll need to pay shipping on them, and that might cost as much as the snake. After that, you just need a rack or an aquarium with a secure lid. You're gonna need a water bowl, substrate, hides. You're gonna need something to heat it, like heat tape, heat mat, heat cable, and a thermostat to control whatever heating element you decide to use. After that, you're good to go. We'll have links to those things down in the description, so feel free to check those out. In fact, if you use those links, it helps out our channel, so we'd really appreciate it. So for these reasons, we give gopher, pine, and bull snakes an overall score of 4 out of 5. If you want a snake that is similar in size and care to a corn snake, but isn't a corn snake, then gopher, bull, and pine snakes might be the perfect pet reptile for you. And if you don't think so, or if you still have some questions, we've got a huge library of other amazing pet reptiles that you should definitely check out, so don't miss those. And as always, like and subscribe, click the little bell so you get a notification whenever another awesome reptile video comes out that you might want to check out, and we hope to see you real soon. Uh-oh, I gotta do it with my right hand because there's no way I'm getting them off the left. Okay.
Pinky first.
That's right, that's right.
It works.
That's how I roll. Okay, I can do this. I can do this. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay. Upfront costs. That's all because of you!